I'm joined by my friend Ronica Cleary. Ronica is a chaser on Chasing News, and she is in New Hampshire right now chasing Donald Trump. That I was talking about Chris Christie earlier. Chris Christie has decided he is going to take advantage of the positive press he got from jumping in the middle of a Trump Fiorina battle at the debate, and he's turned his focus to Carly Fiorina. Now, the question is, can Chris Christie compete with Donald Trump? Donald Trump did a town hall last night in New Hampshire. Ronica was there. Very different from what you would expect from a Chris Christie town hall. Ronica, thanks for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.
Thanks for having me, Bill.
Nice and early. It's early here and in New Hampshire. How are you?
That's true. I'm doing very well, thanks.
So tell me what happened last night. What was the event like?
Well, it was incredibly different from a Christie town hall. I mean, as you know, I have covered a lot of Governor Christie's town halls. In New Jersey, I think the largest I've seen reported is maybe about 500, maybe more than that, 500 people. I asked his people in New Hampshire. They said that Christie's largest town hall was over 300. Well, Donald Trump's town hall last night had over 3,000 people.
Wow.
I mean, the overflow of the audience was actually sitting in bleachers behind the cameras and photographers. And I've never seen anything quite like it. So
wow.
He sort of took questions from each section around him. So he took them from the people in front of him, then turned around and took it from people behind him. He joked that all the people stuck sitting behind him, it was a shame they had to look at his hair, but at least they could see his hair was real. So he had some fun with it.
Yeah.
He took questions rapid fire, and it was very different.
Now, how did he answer the questions? I mean, we've talked about this, you and I, in as you've chased Governor Christie and this whole campaign coming into 2016, and it seems that the big criticism of Trump is that he's light on specifics.
Right. I mean, honestly, Bill, to say answer the questions, that's an exaggeration. I don't think he really did answer a lot of the questions, but I got to give him a little credit. He had fun with it when he didn't answer the questions. I mean, one of the exchanges that really stood out to me was a woman asked him about climate change and his thoughts on it. And he sort of turned to the audience and he said, "Does anyone here believe in climate change?" And a few people raised their hands. And he said, "Look, nobody." And then he just went on to the next question.
I love it.
I will give it to Governor Christie. I mean, he will engage you and answer the questions. You may not agree with his answers. You may feel that he's being dishonest in an answer from time to time. I mean, I see the other reporters on the trail debunk things or say they disagree with it. But he does answer the questions and take time with the people. One woman shared a personal story from what I could gather from what she said of maybe losing her daughter.
Yeah.
And Trump tilted the answer and started talking about Jeb and Common Core.
Unbelievable.
So, I think that was not a good thing, and I think he had an opportunity to really connect with some voters there, and I think he missed that opportunity last night.
Now, what about the crowd? I've only got a little bit of time left, but what about the crowd? What was the crowd like? I've spent time in New Hampshire campaigning, as we talked about yesterday, going back years. What were the people like?
It was like a rock concert. I mean, he had several speakers kind of get the crowd excited before he even came on.
Wow.
And really getting people cheering and chanting and, shouting about America. And I mean, everyone stood up to say the national anthem, and then the room erupted in applause. So it was very exciting. And, everyone keeps saying Donald Trump is tapping into a frustration that Americans have. He's also tapping in a need for feeling excited about politics and their future. And you could definitely feel that there last night.
Wow. All right, Ronica Cleary, thank you for joining me. You can see Ronica tonight on Chasing News. That was the report from the ground at the Donald Trump town hall. Thanks, Ronica.
Thank you, Bill.